Thank you very much. This is our joint talk with Viktor Pavlovich Maslov. In the recent years, Viktor Pavlovich has been developing a new theory of thermodynamics. What I will speak about is our joint paper in which some aspect of this theory was considered, namely the relationship between statistical models of ideal gas and some problems of analytic number theory. Well, this is... So let me start from by quoting Erwin Schrödinger, who says that there is essentially only one problem in statistical thermodynamics, namely the distribution of a given amount of energy E over n identical systems. And this is indeed a very interesting problem. And this problem is clearly related to some problem in number theory. In fact, the relation between partition theory and statistical physics of ideal gases has been long known, and there are very many people who studied this, and I probably will mention Bohr and Kalkar, who were maybe the first to explicitly mention this relationship, and Schrödinger's books also. One of the main difficulties with these talks is that on such topics that there are so many people whom one should necessarily cite that if it properly done, it would take the time of the talk altogether. So the good strategy is to drop those who definitely won't mind. Well, and so I apologize if I somehow do not mention all the people who take part in studying the problems I will discuss here. So let's consider some system of non-interacting particles, and each particle can occupy various energy levels. Let lambda j be the energy value for these energy levels, and nj let be the occupation numbers. That is, nj is the number of particles sitting on the energy level lambda j. Well, then we can consider this system. The total energy of the system of all particles doesn't exceed E, and the total number of particles is equal to m. So this can be the system if the number of particles is fixed, or if we don't fix the number of particles, then we just omit the second relation and use only the first one. And so there are two important problems concerning this inequality or this system. The first system is basically how many solutions does this system have. The logarithm of this number gives us the entropy of the system. And the second problem is what the typical shape of the solution is. And as I said, there are many people who have studied these problems, and as to the number of solutions, I should probably start with Hardy and Ramanujan, who studied the number of partitions of an integer in the integer summons. As to the shape of solutions, well, maybe the earliest papers I know are due to Anatoly Moiseevich Vershik and his colleagues. Well, and there are, in recent time there was also some other papers, I could mention Granovsky and Stark. And while classical number theory deals with the case where these lambda j are integers, In physics, it is generally no reason to assume that these lambda g are integers, and so one deals with some generalization, and this generalization is known under various names, Bjornian numbers or abstract analytic number theory. Here Knopfmacher developed some theory, or just additive analytic number theory, basis of commutative semigroups, which was studied by Postnikov, Bredichin, and others. So this is the case, and I will now give some definitions. Well, time is up. No, not mine. Okay, so we start from arithmetic semigroups. An arithmetic semigroup is a pair consisting of a free commutative semigroup G, which is with countably many generators. That's basically the sum of countably many copies of the group Z plus, and a homomorphism into R plus. And so if these are the generators of the G, that is the basis elements in each copy, then for any element of G, which is represented as this sum with integer coefficients kg, we denote by lambda j the value of this homomorphism on the basis element, and then the homomorphism has this form, d of a is sum of lambda j kg. This is being the direct sum, the number of summons is actually finite by definition. Well, and for each element of an arithmetic semigroup, we also introduce its height a, h of a is just the same sum of kj. Okay. So there are two probably most important problems in classical abstract analytic number theory. Let's introduce two counting functions. The first counting function is the number of elements A in our semigroup G such that D of A doesn't exceed X. And the second counting function is the number of generators of G such that the D of Pj doesn't exceed X. And there are two problems, the direct abstract prime number problem and inverse abstract prime problem. Given one of these functions or its asymptotics, find the other function or its asymptotics as x tends to infinity. The best known examples of these are the problem on the distribution of primes. It is the example of direct abstract prime problem and the partition problem, which is the example of the inverse abstract prime problem. Well, and we can introduce another counting function which counts not all elements with d of a doesn't exceed x, but only those whose height is equal to y. Well, and for counting functions of this sort, we also can consider a problem similar to direct and inverse abstract prime number problem. Okay. So it turns out that ideal gas models can be pretty well turned stated in terms of arithmetic semigroups. Well, so let lambda j be d of pi j and be one particle energy levels in ideal Bose gas. Then there is one-to-one correspondence between the elements of our arithmetic semigroup G and the microstates of the gas with equation numbers kj. Well, the counting function pi g of x is just the spectral counting function of the one-particle Hamiltonian. It counts the eigenvalues of the one-particle Hamiltonian that do not exceed x. And it's the asymptotic of this function as x tends to infinity can be, in some cases, obtained, for example, by the Weyl-Cohen formula. D of A is the energy of the microstate corresponding to the element A. H of A is the number of particles in that microstate. Finally, this function, counting function, gives the number of distinct microstates with energy that doesn't exceed x, and its logarithm gives the entropy. Similarly, if we consider the problem where the number of particles is given, then we use this counting function and instead of this. So, basically, in terms of arithmetic semigroups, computing the entropy is just solving the inverse of such prime problem. This is what concerns the Bose gas case, but we can also consider the case of Fermi gases or Gentile gases. The case of Fermi gas naturally fits in the framework of the abstract analytic number theory. Namely, one says that element of the group G is square free if all KJ are either 0 or 1. It contains no multiples of any generator. Then the counting function of square free elements gives the number of distinct microstates for the case of Fermi statistics. Similar case for the Gentile statistics, when there can be no more than k particles in each state. We can see the k plus 1 free elements in which these kj lie in this set, and then the corresponding counting functions will count the number of states, and the logarithm will give the corresponding entropy. So one can use the technique of theory arithmetic semigroups to compute the entropy for various cases, assuming various asymptotes for the prime counting function. And this indeed has been done, but it turned out that our theory has one drawback. It is that the volume is not present in the theory. And this can be introduced as follows. We consider the width power of the arithmetic semigroup, study the counting function on this width power as V tends to infinity, and compute the entropy and normalize this by dividing by V. And the number V can naturally be interpreted as the volume of the system, and the normalized entropy is just the specific entropy or the entropy per unit volume. Well, okay, so let me be a little bit more specific. So let me make the following assumption, that the counting function of prime elements of generators has these asymptotics as, well, there should be lambda instead of x, well, as lambda tends to infinity. This is basically the asymptotics which would be given by the wire current principle for the case in which of integer gamma, and so we use these asymptotics, but we can also assume that gamma is not necessarily an integer. Next, we introduce the semigroup G of sequences of real elements which decay faster than any inverse power of J, and define homomorphism of G hat into R plus by these formulas. These are basically the same formulas as for the arithmetic semigroup, but extended to these elements, sequences which are not necessarily real. Well, then we have also natural embedding of our arithmetic semigroup G into G hat. Well, and we can define entropy on the arithmetic semigroup as a function on G, which admits a natural extension to G hat in the following way. We consider the mapping of GV into G given by this formula, and for any element of G, define N of AV as a cardinality of the pre-image of the point VA in this GV.
This is what you call entropy?
Sorry?
What is entropy?
Entropy is, I didn't define it, now I haven't defined it yet. So, and we define the entropy of an element A as this limit as V tends to infinity, 1 over V of the logarithm of N AV. And then the entropy is well defined for any element of G, and it is given in fact by this formula. And we see that this function extends to a well-defined function on G hat, just we replace all this Kj by tau j. Well, okay. So, and now we can define, in a sense, the most probable elements of this group hat G by maximizing the entropy. We can maximize if both the energy and the particle density are given, or if only the energy are given. In both cases, we define this the entropy of the conditional maximum. And the theorem said that the most probable shape in this setting is the Bose-Einstein distribution given by this formula, where beta and nu are determined from this system of equations. So the entropy is given by this well-known formula. Yeah. My time is up, so I am finished. Let me also mention that these beta and mu serve as Lagrange multipliers, which permits us to define Lagrangian manifolds associated with this arithmetic semigroup. Well, okay, let's... As usual, we have no time for questions. So thank you once more. Okay.